President, please be seated. The court is back in session and the floor is given to the defense teams for the accused. And first, you may now proceed, the defense team for Mr. Nguyen Chia.
Thank you, Mr. President. Good afternoon, Your Honours. Good afternoon, Mr. Witness. I have some questions for you. Earlier this morning, you testified that you joined military forces in 1973 to fight the forces of Lon Nol. Did you join in 1973 because of a call from late King Father Sihanouk to join the forces, or was it another reason that made you join at the time?
L'avez-vous fait pour une autre raison?
Answer. There was a call in various villages to join the forces in order to save some like a. And at that time, Mong Le Wei asked me to go with him.
And the forces that you joined in 1973, were they called the Khmer Rouge forces, or were they called the Cambodian People's National Liberation Armed Forces?
Forces Armées Nationales de Libération du Cambodge.
Answer. It was called Khmer Rouge Force by some, and some others called Cambodian People National Liberation Forces.
And when you joined in 1973, did you get a military training? Did they teach you how to use guns, how to ambush the enemy, all kinds of things like this?
De formation de la sorte.
Answer. I was
réponse.
Strange how to hold rifles and guns, but a very brief training.
How long did your training last?
Question. Est-ce que votre formation a duré longtemps?
Answer.
Réponse.
It was perhaps 3 days training.
La formation a duré peut-être 3 jours.
Did you ever engage in active combat between 73 and 17 April 75? Did you actually shoot your rifle at enemy forces?
Votre fusil pour tirer sur des forces ennemies, avez-vous jamais pris part à un combat?
Answer, yes.
Réponse.
I used to be in the battlefield.
J'ai été sur le front de bataille.
In Kampong Chinang.
À Kampong Chinang.
It was called Tulip battlefield.
C'était
I was engaged in that Tulip battlefield.
Et j'ai été mobilisé.
Did you get wounded, or did your
question,
comrades
été blessé?
Get wounded?
Vos camarades ont-ils été blessés?
Answer. Some
réponse.
Were wounded and some were
certaines
dead.
Personnes ont été blessées, d'autres sont mortes.
How about yourself? Did you get wounded?
Avez-vous été blessé?
No.
Réponse.
I was not injured at that time.
Je n'ai pas été blessé à ce moment-là.
I suffered from an injury after 1979.
J'ai eu une blessure, mais après 1979.
When you were engaged in fighting in combat between 73 and April 75, did you sometimes work at night?
Par moment, la nuit?
Mm.
Donc, on club tour.
Yes.
Réponse oui.
And since I was young at that time, I was not actively engaged at night time, and only my senior colleague who was actively engaged in the work were allowed to work mostly at night.
Do you remember in those years that you were actively engaged in combat, how much food you had per day? How much rice did you eat per day, you and your comrades?
I could not recall it. It happened a long time ago. I did not recall about the food ration.
I understand. Did you or comrades in the forces suffer from malaria?
Avez-vous jamais souffert du paludisme?
Answer yes. Many of us suffered from malaria.
Beaucoup d'entre nous avons attrapé le paludisme.
And many of us got malaria at different occasions.
When you were fighting, when you were in combat, did you have proper bathrooms?
Aviez-vous des toilettes en bonne et due forme?
No.
Réponse non.
We had our own water container.
Nous avions
with
notre
us.
Propre conteneur
d'eau. No toilet.
Sur nous, pas de toilette.
And there were no proper eating place
et
as well.
Il n'y avait pas non plus de lieu pour manger.
Did you or your comrades sometimes suffer from diarrhea?
Camarades, avez-vous jamais attrapé la diarrhée?
Answer.
Réponse.
Yes.
Oui.
Diarrhea and dysentery.
Diarrhée et dysenterie.
A few of them or some of them got diarrhea and dysentery.
Certains d'entre eux ont attrapé, ou certains d'entre nous avons attrapé
Did,
la diarrhée.
You or maybe some of your comrades get injured because of accidents.
Camarades avaient été peut-être blessés au cours d'un accident. Est-ce le cas?
Some cadres suffered injury, and as for myself, I did not get any injury. I was asked mostly to go and collect rice for soldiers.
Thank you. Mr. Witness, let me now turn to the period after 1975. The division that you worked in as a soldier was turned into Division 502. Do you know why it was this division that became responsible for or constituted the Air Force of the Revolutionary Army of Kampuchea? Why was it 502 that became the Air Force?
Pourquoi la division 502 particulièrement?
Answer, I do not know.
Réponse, je n'en sais rien.
I have no idea the responsibility of 502.
Je ne sais pas quelles étaient les responsabilités de la
502. Let us now turn to February, March, 1976, the period in time that you said you left for Kampong Chinang Airfield. You were a member of Division 502. Do you remember in which squad, which group, which platoon, which company, which battalion you were in? Do you remember the numbers of these respective units?
Unités vous appartiez?
Answer, I cannot remember all of them.
Were you maybe in Regiment 51, or were you in Regiment 53, or were you in Battalion 503, or Battalion 504, or were you at the division office? Do you remember where you were in this division?
Don't call it. Call it.
Answer.
Réponse.
I knew only 130 and 132.
130 et 131.
And
c'est
as
ce
for
que je connaissais.
51, 52,
en ce qui concerne
I have
51,
no idea.
52, je n'en sais rien.
I understand.
Je comprends.
From your testimony, I understood that Levay, Commander Levay, sent you on a mission to Kampong Chnang Airfield in about February or March. But you also said that people within your division were thinking that you have that you had what you call tendencies. Can you explain to me how it was possible at the time that, on the one hand, people were saying that you had tendencies, but on the other hand, Commander Levay picked you and apparently nine others to do the preparatory work at Kampong Chnang Airfield.
Wow.
Answer. It was said that I had a tendency. That is why I was transferred to centers elsewhere away from the way. I was removed from my squad. And the workers in the garage worked full day at that time, and it was like the place that they were re-educated and refashioned, and I was transferred into that garage squad.
I understand, but I think you also testified that you belong to an advanced group of 10 cadres joined by Chinese advisors to start preliminary work on a very secretive airfield. So can you reconcile the two? One, you having tendencies, and two, this apparent secret mission to start building the airport.
Cette mission secrète qui consistait à bâtir l'aéroport, alors que d'autre part, on considérait que vous aviez des tendances.
Answer. I have no idea on this point. I noticed that those who were affiliated with the former regime were sent out, and they underwent hard labor afterwards. They were removed from the office.
On les a retirés du bureau ou de leurs
It was like that we were refashioned after they found out that we were affiliated with the former regime, and we were told to well behave.
Et on nous disait de bien nous comporter.
I was afraid that I would be arrested at that time, so I tried to work very hard.
Alors j'ai travaillé dur.
I'm having difficulty to understand your testimony. You were sent to Kampong Chnang Airfield in February, March 76, together with 9 or 10 other people, only with Chinese advisors. Then subsequently you were working at the garage. That doesn't really sound like refashioning to me. It sounds more like you were instructed as a soldier to do necessary military work. Or am I wrong?
Du fait qu'on vous a demandé en tant que soldat de mener à bien un travail militaire qui était nécessaire.
Answer.
Réponse.
the place where I work could be compared to the engineering squad nowadays.
Exactly. So why do you call it refashioning? I don't understand.
Exactement. Alors pourquoi appelez-vous cela rééducation pour être reforgé?
I stated that because I was told to work full day every day before I was working in a more relaxed team and groups, and now I was moved and transferred to the squad that I had to work a full day every day.
Dans laquelle je devais travailler toute la journée.
And when I was moved to the garage squad, the food ration was not like before. I did not have enough food.
Je n'avais plus suffisamment à manger.
The Revolutionary Army of Kampuchea was formed, I believe, in the summer of 1975,
the rainy season 75.
What was the task of the Revolutionary Army of Kampuchea, to which Division 502 belonged? What were the two tasks of every soldier within the Revolutionary Army?
Answer.
Réponse.
Some were tasked with protection, and some were tasked with construction work, and some other would be assigned to dig the canals
et certains d'entre nous devaient creuser des canaux.
Or to work in the field.
Travailler dans les champs.
And as I stated, some groups were asked to work in the construction team. So these are the tasks and duties of the soldiers.
Thank you for that answer. And doesn't the work at Kampong Chang Airfield done by the soldiers fit exactly in the task of the Revolutionary Army, which is to defend and build up the country?
Ne correspondait-elle pas au travail des soldats de l'armée révolutionnaire, à savoir bâtir et protéger.
I only noticed that soldiers were called into that work site.
Soldiers,
many of soldiers were called in to work there.
Appelés pour travailler sur
and
ce site.
We did the work
according
to their call or their instructions.
En conséquence, selon les instructions.
I understand, Mr. Witness. Earlier this morning, you used the words when you were describing tasks of the army. You used the words core task.
Fondamental pour décrire le
the work
tâche, donc la tâche
done by soldiers
principale.
In 76 to begin with. Wasn't that the core task of Division 502? Building up an airport in order to defend the country.
Qui consistait à construire un aéroport pour défendre le pays, ne faisait-elle pas partie des tâches fondamentales?
I have no idea whether their task was to defend and protect the country.
De protéger et de
we were told to be engaged in the construction, and we complied with the instruction, and I have no idea about the thing that you stated.
I understand, Mr. Witness. Before I will ask you a few questions on about the conditions on Kampong Chang Airfield, I would like to ask you some other questions. I believe after liberation, you were also stationed at Pochentong Airport. Were you able to see, in that period in time, you belonging to the Air Force Division, of which military planes or helicopters the Air Force of Democratic Kampuchea consisted of? How many helicopters, how many planes did Division 502 have?
Combien d'hélicoptères avait la Division 502?
Answer, I do not know. I cannot recall it. I did not dare to go inside and have a look. Only those who were tasked with a specific assignment could go into that place. I was guarding, I was staying east of the airport. And I would see airplanes every 2 days or every fortnight, and I did not see airplanes every day.
I understand that you were not allowed to go into hangars, but is it fair to say that the Air Force of Kampuchea, the Democratic Kampuchea in 75-76, consisted of only a very few Dragonfly helicopters and one or two very old propeller American planes, airplanes? Would that be a fair summary?
President, please hold on, Mr. Winnet. You may now proceed. International Deputy Co-Prosecutor.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
Yes, thank you, Mr. President. This is hautement suggestive,
a very suggestive question here
that introduces
evidence that we don't know where it comes from. There's no mention of documents, there are no references, nothing that allows us to give objective value to what
Donc,
Council Coppe is sharing with us. So if he wishes
to refer to documents, he should do so
before putting these questions to the witness. Thank you.
It's not a very important question, but the information comes from a document that the prosecution itself uploaded on the interface. So, I'll move on. One other question that I have to you, Mr. Witness, that's also relating to situation that Division 502 might have been dealing with. Have you heard in February, March 76 anything about bombing by jet fighter planes of Siem Reap, bombing that occurred on 26 February 1976?
Le 26 février 1976 de la ville de Siem Reap, au-dessus de Siem Reap.
I did not know. I never heard of it.
Je n'en sais rien, je n'en ai jamais entendu parler.
I never heard people saying about this incident.
Je n'ai jamais entendu les gens parler de cet incident.
I was asking you because you said you were close to Deputy Commander Lavey. You don't remember him saying anything about this? Or something, or hear something on the radio? Radio Phnom Penh saying something about bombing of Siem Reap?
Radio Phnom Penh, le bombardement de Siem Reap?
Answer, no. I never heard of it.
Réponse, non, je n'en ai jamais entendu parler.
Have you ever heard of grenades being thrown at the Royal Palace at around the same time, February, March
1976? Des grenades auraient été lancées contre le palais.
No, I did not know. I never heard of it. People did not mention about this, and there were no broadcasts. It was quite silent at that time.
I understand. Now moving on to the Kampongchang airfield. You said that you were one of the first cadres from 502 to arrive at the scene. Is it correct that in Kampongchang, in the surroundings, there was also an airstrip already built by the Americans that was subsequently used by Division 502? Or do you know nothing about an airstrip which was built by American forces earlier?
Au préalable par les forces américaines.
I heard it was located
réponse.
In the west of Kampong Chenang.
J'ai entendu dire new que airfield. C'était à l'ouest du nouvel aéroport de Kampong Chenang.
How far west was it? How
question.
Far from the ultimate location of Kampong Chenang airfield?
Par rapport à l'aéroport.
Answer.
Réponse.
It was perhaps 20 kilometers away from the Kampong Chenang airport construction site. Perhaps 20 kilometers away from my estimate.
So it wasn't used at all by Division 502, is that correct?
Answer. No, it was not used. The old strip was not used.
L'ancienne piste n'était pas utilisée.
And they planned to use the new strip, but the new strip had not been completely built.
Mais la nouvelle piste n'était pas encore terminée.
Thank you, Mr. Witness. Now,
question, je vous remercie,
moving
Mr.
on Mr. to your work at...
Je passe à présent à votre travail.
At the airfield. You said that your work consisted mostly of taking care of the vehicles in the garage. Am I too simple now in my summary, or is that basically the task that you were doing?
Answer. I did not know how to repair anything other than the building the garage. I did not know how to repair the vehicle. I was engaged in building the garage hall. It was an other squad who was in charge of repairing vehicles.
And were you also a driver, or were you only involved in building the garage?
Votre tâche était-elle, consistait-elle seulement à construire le garage?
Answer. No, I could not drive a vehicle.
Je ne pouvais pas conduire les véhicules.
I was there to repair the garage, not the vehicles.
Garage, pas les véhicules.
I was there to mend, to re-innovate the garage.
J'étais là-bas pour rénover.
And again, I did not
garage.
Know how to repair the vehicle.
I understand.
Maybe you gave testimony to this, but I'm not 100% sure if I heard it. Was this the main task of you being in the garage, building the garage, or were there other jobs that you did subsequently before 79? Or was this the main focus, or was this the main element of your work?
After I was told to build and repair the garage, I was then told to go and grow vegetables.
J'ai dû aller faire pousser des légumes.
We did the construction during the daytime, perhaps in the morning, and in the afternoon,
nous
we had to go
le matin, et
to grow vegetables.
Nous devions nous occuper des légumes.
But working in the garage and growing
vegetables,
was that
faire pousser des légumes,
all you did until the Vietnamese came?
Faire jusqu'à l'arrivée des Vietnamiens?
Pour le gang answer. I did these two assignments until the Vietnamese came into the country.
And at that time, we fled and we parted each other.
I understand. Now, Mr. Witness, can you explain to me
why your working conditions at the airfield were so much tougher
than when you were in combat, when your comrades died, you were living under harsh conditions? Why is it so much worse currently after May or March, April 76? Can you explain that to me?
Vos conditions de travail étaient plus pénibles. En mars 76.
Answer.
Réponse.
The work became more difficult because I was told to work day and night, and the disciplines were becoming stricter and stricter.
Much work
that we had to do,
il y avait beaucoup
and
de travail
four
à accomplir.
Or ten of us needed to complete the task that we were asked to do. If we could not complete,
à travailler, we nous devions faire
would
tout
be
ce que nous
reprimanded.
De faire, et si ce n'était pas le cas, nous étions réprimandés.
But complete exactly what?
Question.
You were repairing garage, the garage, and you were building, you were growing vegetables.
Vous répariez le garage,
what were your quota? What exactly
légumes
did you have to do?
Que deviez-vous faire exactement? Quel était le quota à respecter? Qu'est-ce qui rendait les choses si difficiles que cela?
The work was difficult, as
réponse,
I told you. Sometimes I couldn't finish the work, or to meet the deadline as they requested.
Les délais qui avaient été fixés.
And I didn't have enough break time. Sometimes I only had an hour break time,
parfois,
and I had to resume at 7 p.m.
But you were a revolutionary soldier, Mr. Witness.
Question, mais vous étiez un soldat
révolutionnaire,
monsieur
le témoin.
Vous deviez
surely
construire le pays, le défendre.
Not having an hour break is not that bad.
Le fait de ne pas avoir autre chose qu'une heure de pause n'est pas si difficile que cela.
I didn't hear your answer, but you said
Maître
yes, Copé, is that correct?
Je n'ai pas entendu votre réponse. Avez-vous dit oui?
Va. Yes.
Le témoin.
Oui. Just a second, please.
La juge Pence. Un instant, s'il vous plaît.
Bah, that didn't look good. Counsel Copper, please wait.
Maître Copé, veuillez attendre, s'il vous plaît.
President, Judge Fence, you have the floor.
As counsel well knows, the question is based on a misrepresentation of facts. The witness didn't say the only reason why it was difficult is because he didn't have 1 hour break. So we advised the witness not to answer, and the question, its tendency was inappropriate.
And why is that, Judge Fence?
You know why.
No, I don't. Explain to me, please.
Non, je ne sais pas. Veuillez me l'expliquer, s'il vous plaît.
I'm happy to reread. Frankly, for me, you sounded as if you were a person from that time, reminding the witness, threatening the witness, reminding the witness of his obligations. There are other ways to put a question.
Il y a d'autres façons de poser des questions.
I should not say what I want to say now. I'll move on, Mr. Witness.
Je ne vais pas dire ce que je voulais dire maintenant.
The other cadres from Division 502,
les autres cadres de la Division 502,
started working in 76
et ont commencé à travailler en 1976 sur le terrain d'aviation.
Were they? Let me first ask you the question. How many cadres of 502 started working at Division at the airfield? Were there hundreds, were there thousands of Division 502 working at the airfield?
Un millier de cadres de la Division 502?
I do not know the total number.
Je ne sais pas combien ils étaient au total.
I had no idea at all.
Je n'en ai aucune idée.
Some had been transferred to work at the airport work site, while others were transferred to work at the provincial town of Kampong Chinan.
Aller travailler dans le chef-lieu de province de Kampong Chinan.
So I cannot tell you the total number of cadres or the total number of soldiers from the division.
De soldats de la division il y avait.
But were most soldiers who came to work in the early months after February, March 76, did they belong to Division 502?
Appartenaient-ils, oui ou non, à la Division 502?
President, witness, please wait. And the international deputy co-prosecutor, you have the floor.
Merci. Je crois que la question est un petit peu ambiguë parce que elle est très générale et elle ne distingue pas les différentes phases d'arrivée de soldats ou de travailleurs sur le site. Donc, si c'est immédiatement après son arrivée, je comprends. Mais si il fait référence également à des militaires venant d'autres divisions, je crois qu'alors la question n'est pas assez précise et pourrait laisser le témoin dans le doute concernant la portée de la question.
Je vais reformuler.
The first 6 months after your arrival,
how many cadres
were roughly working, and were they mostly from Division 502?
Combien de cadres travaillaient-ils sur place, et combien venaient de la Division 502?
Initially, there were about 10 of us, or a bit above that, maybe 10 to 20 soldiers.
Peut-être entre 10 et 20
but
soldats.
I did not know everyone.
Mais je ne connaissais pas tout le monde.
So the figure is between 10 to 15 or to 20.
Entre 10, 15 et 20.
But I'm now referring to the moment when there were many soldiers.
Je parle à présent du moment où beaucoup de soldats sont arrivés sur le terrain d'aviation.
When did that happen? Was that in the first 6 months after your arrival?
Quand cela s'est-il produit? Pendant les 6 mois qui ont suivi
votre arrivée? Can you tell us something about the build-up of forces
working at the airfield? Les renforts sont arrivés sur le terrain d'aviation.
I think the number between 1976 to 1977 increased to about 1,000 workers.
Je dirais que le nombre d'ouvriers est passé à 1,000.
I cannot tell you the exact figure. This is just my estimate. As various units worked at various locations, some worked at the far end of the airfield work site. So I cannot say whether my estimate is correct.
Mon estimation est correcte ou non.
And these 1,000 soldiers, were they mainly from Division 502, or did they also come from other divisions?
Principalement à la division 502, ou bien appartenaient-ils à d'autres divisions?
Most of the workers came from the division,
des ouvriers venaient de cette
or
division,
from the east zone,
ou de la zone est,
or from the other zones,
d'autres
since
zones.
I did not know exactly which zones they
sachant
came from. However, the field, the work site, was full of
je
worker
sais que le
soldiers.
Terrain d'aviation était plein d'ouvriers, soldats.
And only when I came to the work site, then I realized that
ce
there were many workers
place,
on site.
Y avait autant d'ouvriers sur
Let's concentrate on the soldiers from Division 502.
Concentrons-nous sur les soldats de la division 502.
Between the moment that you came and 77.
Entre le moment de votre arrivée et 1977.
Do you know assigned to work there? Because of them belonging to the Air Force Division, or with, like yourself, or
leur
were they there working
sur le
for other reasons?
Parce qu'ils appartenaient à l'armée de l'air, comme vous-même, ou bien leur a-t-on demandé de le faire pour d'autres raisons?
Not all soldiers came from the Air Force.
Les soldats
many of them came from various other zones or from various districts.
De différents districts.
And some soldiers, like myself,
certains
who were familiar with the geography of the terrain, were assigned to work at the airfield work site as well.
But do you know whether these forces comprising of about 1,000 soldiers were sent to work at Kampong Chang airfield because of their military work, because that was part of their military duty, or were they sent there for some punishment reasons?
Si ces personnes avaient été envoyées pour, en guise de sanctions.
To my understanding, some soldiers were sent to work there as part of their military duties, while others were there when they were being disciplined. And they were sent there for refashioning.
Now let's focus on that last group. Can you give me any example of some soldier from one zone or another zone that was working in that first year because he was being refashioned? Do you remember a name? Do you remember the reason? What can you tell us?
De quoi vous souvenez-vous? Que pouvez-vous nous dire?
I do not recall any.
Réponse.
I only knew that they were sent from various zones, mostly from the east zone, and some were sent from the southwest zone or from the west zone.
But I presume that those thousand soldiers from the various zones that you were speaking about in that first year were all doing maybe the same work at the airfield. Which ones were there because of refashioning reasons, and how were you able to tell that that was the reason that they were there?
Et comment pouviez-vous savoir qu'ils étaient là-bas dans ce but?
I learned that most of the soldiers sent from the East Zone were those who were sent for refashioning, as I observed that they were the target groups for the arrest.
Let's talk about these East Zone soldiers.
Reparlons à présent de ces soldats de la zone Est.
When was it that they were coming to the airfield because of refashioning reasons? Was that 76 or was that 77 or maybe even only in 78?
En 76, en 77 ou seulement en 78 pour y être rééduqué?
It is about 1977 when they arrived.
C'était en 1977 qu'ils sont arrivés.
Was it the end of 77?
Question.
Could that be?
Peut-être fin 1977?
No.
Réponse,
not
non.
Towards the end of 77.
Non.
It happened either
77.
In early or in
plutôt
mid 1977.
Début, 1977.
But I cannot say that it is the exact month of
mais
their arrival.
Vous donner le mois exact de leur arrivée.
I understand. Let's then speak about
question.
The forces that you saw working at the airfield in the second half of 1976.
Au cours du deuxième semestre 1976.
How could you establish that any of the soldiers working at the airfield in 1976 were there because of refashioning reasons?
Avaient été envoyés pour y être rééduqués.
I know that during the period of 1977, workers were started to work much harder than they were previously engaged in, and sometimes the food was barely enough for us, and they had to concentrate on their work. And sometimes there was not even a break time during the working hours.
I was asking you, Mr. Witness, about 1976. So that was before the time you said East Zone soldiers came to Kampong Chiang because of refashioning reasons. Were you able to make any observation in 1976 as to refashioning reasons for soldiers to be there, to work there?
Comment avez-vous pu savoir que certains soldats étaient là pour être rééduqués?
I observed that soldiers were not allowed to wander freely, and the food ration was rather restricted as well. So there was no liberty at all in going here or there, and even for a quick bath, we were not allowed to take a long bath at all.
Se doucher longuement.
Our freedom was very limited when we were there.
Notre liberté était donc très limitée lorsque nous étions là-bas.
This morning you testified that
question,
you were allowed
matin,
to leave the airfield and work at the rice fields of the villagers.
Pour aller travailler dans les rizières avec les villageois.
How does that correspond with what you just said?
Quel est le lien par rapport à ce que vous venez de dire?
I withdraw the question.
Je retire la question.
Mr. Witness, in 1976, do you
Monsieur
know
le témoin, en 1976, how many
tons of rice each soldier was awarded or was given?
Était remise aux soldats.
No.
Réponse, non.
We were not given rice or unhusked rice individually.
L'on ne nous donnait pas de riz décortiqué de façon individuelle, absolument pas.
Do you know whether
Question.
The amount of rice that was given to you
Savez-vous
in 1976
si
was the same
en 1976
as each of the 5 or 6,000 members of Division 502?
N'était la même que celle des 500 ou 600 soldats de la Division 502.
Let me rephrase.
Je vais reformuler.
Was there a difference within Division 502
y avait-il
between
des différences de traitement
certain soldiers of certain squads or platoons,
les soldats de la division
or was everyone,
de
to your knowledge, within Division 502 getting the same amount of rice?
Ou bien chacun recevait la même ration que les autres?
I do not have a clue about that. In fact, the ration was given to the group as a whole and not to an individual soldier. And we cooked and we ate communally together in the group.
Nous cuisinions et nous mangeons
sometimes
tous ensemble.
We had gruel. And I could not say about the food ration for other groups or units.
But do you know if there was any distinction between the various platoons or groups or companies within Division 502? Or was everybody in that division getting the same amount of rice per day?
Ou si tous ces groupes, unités, recevaient les mêmes rations chaque jour?
I am not sure on this
Réponse.
Point.
Je ne sais
I
pas
do not know whether the food ration was distributed equally across the units.
Si
it was the group chief who went to receive the rice for the group.
I understand, but did the group chief or the platoon chief or the
Question,
company
mais
chief,
les chefs de
or
compagnie,
the
de section, de groupe,
battalion chief
bataillon,
ever say that your unit had less food
disait-il parfois
than other
que
units?
Votre unité recevait moins de nourriture qu'une autre?
Wow. Yes, I heard about that.
Oui, j'en ai entendu parler.
But I simply did not know how much rice that other units received.
Mais je n'ai pas su combien de riz était remis aux autres unités.
Because we stayed at our separate quarters.
Nous vivions dans des endroits séparés.
So you only can say something about the food
Question.
Within your unit that
Vous
was stationed at the garage, is that correct?
Vous ne pouvez donc parler que de la nourriture pour votre unité, celle qui s'occupait du garage, n'est-ce pas?
Yes, that is true. I only knew about what happened at the building where my group stayed.
Dans le bâtiment dans lequel mon groupe séjournait.
Did you ever hear
Question.
From your group unit chief, for your
chef
group chief, or your unit chief, or anybody else within
groupe,
your division
d'autre de votre
about
division?
Armed clashes
a-t-il parlé de
in the east zone between east zone
Est,
forces and
entre
central
les forces
forces
de l'est et les forces du centre.
No, I did not.
Non.
I did not hear anything of that nature from my group chief or unit
mon
chief.
Mon chef d'unité, mon chef de groupe, on n'a pas parlé
de cela. Did you hear in 1978 anything about an uprising of forces in the East Zone or a rebellion of East Zone forces?
Dans la zone Est.
No.
Réponse, non.
I was not aware of that. I only heard that there was a rebellion by factory workers.
J'ai entendu parler d'une
but
rébellion
I did not hear any rebellion by
mais
soldiers.
J'ai pas entendu parler de rébellion de soldats.
And I heard about the rebellion by the factory workers
by the des ouvriers de l'usine.
Member of my group.
Ce sont des membres de mon groupe qui m'en ont parlé.
Did you ever hear
question.
About tens of thousands
avez-vous
of
entendu parler de dizaines
Khmer Rouge soldiers
de soldats Khmer Rouge
dying in combat
qui
in 1978, fighting Vietnamese forces?
En luttant contre les forces vietnamiennes?
No, I did not hear about that.
Réponse, non, je n'en ai pas entendu parler.
Nobody told me about that.
Personne ne m'en a parlé.
Did you ever hear about East Zone soldiers
being considered as prisoners of war? Avez-vous entendu dire que les soldats de la zone Est étaient considérés comme des prisonniers de guerre?
Yes, I heard people say
oui,
that.
J'ai entendu des gens le dire.
And as I said, I heard about this from members of my group.
Des membres de mon groupe en ont parlé.
And what is it exactly
question.
That you heard
qu'avez-vous
about this?
Entendu exactement à ce sujet?
I heard members of my group
réponse.
Say about
des membres
that
de
event,
mon groupe en ont parlé, ont parlé de
and
cet événement.
I only listened to what they said.
Je me suis contenté d'écouter ce qu'ils disaient.
But do you remember what it was that they
question.
Said to you?
Mais vous souvenez-vous de ce qu'ils vous ont dit? Réponse.
I cannot recall it.
Je ne m'en souviens pas.
Do you remember the
question.
Names of
vous souvenez-vous
rather the numbers of the various divisions
noms, plutôt des chiffres associés
in Democratic Kampuchea within the Revolutionary Army?
Do
you know, for instance, the number
exemple,
of the division of East Zone soldiers? You were belonging to 502. What was the number of the division of East Zone forces?
Quel était le chiffre associé à la division des forces de l'Est?
I do not have a clue about that.
Réponse, je n'en ai aucune idée.
Do you remember any number of a division?
Vous souvenez-vous de quelques chiffres que ce
coming
soit
from other zones?
Qui auraient été associés à des divisions appartenant à d'autres zones?
I cannot recall
réponse.
It.
Réponse, non, je ne m'en souviens pas.
What can you tell us
question.
About the number of Chinese advisors
que pouvez-vous nous dire
working at the
aux
airfield?
Conseillers chinois qui travaillaient sur le terrain d'aviation?
How many were there in the beginning and how many were
combien
there at the end?
Combien étaient-ils au départ et combien étaient-ils à la fin?
I do not know later on how many Chinese were there on site. I only knew at the beginning
Chinois
that there were about 10 Chinese technical
départ,
advisors who conducted a terrain survey
ce
or measurement and
terrain,
who
effectuer les mesures nécessaires,
the sketch of the airport project.
Les plans pour le projet de l'aéroport.
However, there were other Chinese working
Mais
in various other sections. For example, there were Chinese working for the steam roller section or for other heavy machinery sections.
Did
you ever hear the number of 6,000 military Chinese advisors?
6,000 conseillers militaires chinois.
I withdraw the question.
Je retiens ma question.
Mr. Witness, you said at one point in time that there were soldiers surveilling.
Qu'à un moment donné, il y avait des soldats.
What was the exact reason for these soldiers to surveil?
Qui surveillaient.
Was it because of
Pourquoi
external security or was it because of internal security reasons?
Externe ou interne?
I made some observations on their activities, but I didn't know much about the nature of their work. And while they were working, there were also some security force who were posting near where they were working. And I only knew well about the nature of my work, that is working at a garage.
Le seul travail dont je connaissais bien la nature, c'était le
mien. That I, if I say that the building of this airfield was a highly secretive operation, nobody was supposed to know.
Une opération hautement secrète et que personne n'était censé savoir.
The thing is, no one who was not authorized could enter the premises of the work site, so I could draw a conclusion that it was a secret project. Ordinary civilians were not allowed to trespass the area at all.
So, is it possible that these soldiers surveilling were there to keep intruders away rather than to look over other soldiers while working?
Plutôt que pour surveiller les soldats qui travaillaient.
Ordinary civilians were not allowed to go into the work site. No ordinary civilians and citizens. And I could not see other soldiers as well. At the first stage, I could only see the 10 Chinese technicians.
Thank you, Mr. Witness.
President, now the chamber gives the floor to the defense team for Mr. Kisampong. You may not proceed. Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you, Your Honors. Good afternoon, Mr. Kin. I have a few questions for your clarification. First, I would like to know your exact position at the Kampong Chenang airfield. You stated that you arrived at that airfield in February or March 1976. You were there with the Chinese technician to make the measurement of the terrain or land, and Song was your superior at that time. And afterwards, you were transferred to work in the garage under Song's supervision. Do I understand correctly that you were assigned and you were holding these two positions until you were transferred out of Kampong Chinang airfield?
Que vous avez gardé ces deux fonctions, occupé ces fonctions et gardé ces fonctions.
Answer, yes, that
vous
is
avez
correct.
Été muté à l'extérieur de Kampong Chinang.
Counsel.
Réponse, oui, c'est exact. Question.
Could you tell the court how long did you work for Song while working with the 10 Chinese technicians?
Pour Song avec, aux côtés des 10 techniciens chinois.
Answer.
Réponse.
I spent 1 week working for Song, and after that
Song.
I was
removed
from that squad.
On m'a
perhaps 1 week or so.
Au bout peut-être d'une
Counsel.
Semaine.
After your removal,
question. Et une fois que vous avez été
were
retiré
you
de
sent immediately to the garage squad, or did you work in other places before you were at the garage?
Avant de venir au garage?
Answer.
Réponse.
I was transferred immediately to
on
the
garage.
I was there to build the garage. I did not spend time working in other places after I was removed from my first position.
Une fois que l'on m'a retiré de ma première fonction.
Counsel, thank you very much. I would like to seek your clarification on your duties at the
garage.
Was there only one garage that you work, or were there many other garages?
Ou plusieurs garages pour lesquels vous travaillez?
Answer.
Réponse.
I had to move from one garage to another garage.
After I built one garage, I had to move to build another garage.
So there were many garages.
Donc il y avait plusieurs garages.
Counsel, thank you.
La défense, merci.
You move to build garages from one place to another. Were all garages in the premise of the airfield?
Est-ce que les garages se trouvaient sur
President,
le terrain?
President, please wait. Please observe the microphone, the Mr. Witness.
L'aéroport, président, veuillez attendre, Monsieur le témoin, veuillez respecter.
Answer.
Le microphone, assurez-vous qu'il soit bien allumé avant de parler.
Actually, the garage were not in the premise of the airfield work site. They were surrounding the airfield. Some garage were about 8 or 9 meters away from the airfield work site.
8 ou 9 mètres du site.
Counsel, thank you. Do you recall how many garages were built by your squad?
Merci. Vous souvenez-vous combien de garages ont été bâtis par votre escouade?
Answer. I could not recall it because
réponse,
it happened a long time ago. I did
longtemps.
Not know how many garages I built
je ne sais pas combien de garages
near
j'ai
the airfield.
Bâtir près.
The garage were located in the east and in the west of the airfield work site. Counsel, could you clarify this for the court? What were the garages made of?
De quoi étaient faits les garages? En quoi étaient-ils construits?
The garage was made of wood.
Le garage était fait de bois.
And the garage was used for parking vehicles.
Est-elle utilisée pour garer des véhicules?
Counsel.
L'avocat.
You were assigned to build the garage for parking vehicles and
on vous a demandé
heavy
de
machinery.
Construire des garages afin de garer les véhicules et les engins lourds.
Did you work continuously or
de façon
did you
continue?
Have a break after you completed building one garage?
Pause lorsque vous aviez terminé de construire un bâtiment, un garage?
Answer. After I completely built one garage, I had to move to another place and build a new garage. I had only the lunch break. And at night time, I also built the garage, so I worked at night as well. I did not have a time to rest at night time. Counsel, thank you.
L'avocat, je vous remercie.
I heard your testimony earlier that you went through health transplanting rice seedlings and you also stated that you were assigned to grow vegetables. Were you assigned to go and break rocks
and drill rocks? Et de forer la roche.
Answer, no.
Réponse, non.
I was not assigned to break rocks. And also I was not assigned to go and put explosive in order to break rocks. I was only working at the garage.
Je travaillais au garage seulement.
Counsel, thank you.
L'avocat, je vous remercie.
Could you clarify your statement for the chamber?
Pourriez-vous préciser votre déclaration?
You stated that you were assigned to construct the garage and also to grow vegetables and to find
that
trunks of trees. What kind of work did you spend a long time?
Du bois. À quelle tâche avez-vous consacré le plus de temps?
Answer. I started constructing the garage from 7 a.m. until 10 or 11 a.m. in the morning. And after that, I had a short rest. And in the morning, if I was not building the garage, I had to go and transplant rice seedlings.
Je devais aller m'occuper du repiquage du riz.
And in the afternoon, I had to resume work growing vegetables until 5 p.m. And at night, I worked from 7 p.m. until 10 p.m.
Le soir, je travaillais de 7 heures
Counsel,
à 10 heures.
Thank you.
La défense,
Were these your daily tasks?
S'agissait-il là de vos tâches quotidiennes?
Answer, yes.
Oui.
These were all my daily tasks.
C'était là toutes mes tâches quotidiennes.
In addition to building the garage, I had to go and grow vegetables and transplant rice seedlings. And as I told you already, from 7 to 10 p.m., I had to work as well. Counsel, you stated a while ago that sometimes you did not construct the garage. And you were told to collect the dead stump of tree instead. So how many days were you assigned to build the garage, and how many days were you assigned to go and collect the dead stump of trees?
Passiez-vous à construire le garage et combien de jours passiez-vous à aller chercher le bois?
Answer.
Réponse.
I built the garage during the daytime, and I went to collect dead woods at night.
Je construisais le garage pendant la journée, et le bois, j'allais le chercher pendant la nuit.
And there was lights at night, so that we could go and collect woods. President, thank you. It is now convenient time for a break. The chamber will take a break from now until 3 p.m. Court officer, please facilitate a proper room for this witness. and please invite him back to the courtroom at 3 p.m. The court is now in recess.